More money, a bigger market. This motivated Blinky to migrate north once again. He found a new home on the air at KWGN Channel 2, the place he called home for the next 33 years.
One of the best known at KWGN would go unnoticed by most until a funny bit takes place, then, makeup or not, it's unmistakably Blinky the Clown. Russell Scott admits it seems like he's putting on makeup and washing his face all day long. By mid-afternoon, the big red nose is set in place and Blinky the Clown begins to take shape.
Blinky the Clown created, produced, and hosted 5 shows a week, almost every week of the year. The program format that worked in Colorado Springs also worked in Denver. The shows were still simple and loose. Blinky the Clown invited kids to his clubhouse. They, along with their parents, played the part of an adoring live studio audience. While Blinky played out his vaudeville-style skits, gave his safety advice, reminded kids to mind their moms and dads, and of course, sang happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Better smile. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear children. Happy birthday to you. And I certainly hope you have a nice birthday all day long.
Any youngster who grew up in Denver with a television in the house knew every note of that rendition. Blinky's version of Happy Birthday was better known than most any top 40 hit on AM radio at the time.
Well, for one thing, it wasn't birthday. If you ever listened to it very carefully, it was birthday. Now, whether that was stemmed from his Oklahoma background, I don't know. It was happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear children. Happy birthday to you. And he did it a lot better than I did.
The crew was small on Blinky's Fun Club. The set and the studio were modest. There were no teams of writers, no layers of management or producers looking over the production. The show was just Blinky, 100% Blinky.
This is Frances, and she's crazy about me. She's from Florida. Come on. Good morning to you. Good morning to you. Good morning, dear Florida. Good morning to you. Hey, how about that? Let's hear it for Florida and Francis.
Whatever Blinky could create and perform without costing the station money usually ended up on the air.
Good morning. Good morning to you. Good morning to you. Good morning, dear children. Good morning to you. Be right back.
Blinky was in his prime. He was in his element.
He was an incredible figure because in Blinky's era, he was a personality. You have to remember a lot of the background because Channel 2 in those days was an independent station. They did not have a network affiliation, so they had a lot of local time on their hands to fill, and Blinky was in an era when live television was really coming onto its own, and he was there, and he was a star in a true sense of the word.
The best part about working with Blinky, I think, was the unpredictability of the show.
Boys and girls, moms and dads, welcome to the all-new Blinky's Fun Club.
Blinky's Fun Club may not have been the best produced television program, but at the time, it was perhaps the most memorable for Denver area children. Out of Blinky's creative freedom came magic little moments.
Good morning to you. Good morning to you. Good morning, dear children. Good morning to you.
Those who were lucky enough to visit the studio had a rare glimpse into a TV station, and they got to meet a real television star, someone they watched on TV every day.
All right, let's see. What do we have here today? First of all, we have a clown. We have chalk. And we have a blackboard. And what do we have out there? We have giggly kids with crayons and paper. You draw along with me. How about drawing, good idea, trees. All right. First, we gotta have a road. All right. Ooh. Now, there is the vanishing point out there. See, it gets real small up. Now, right here, we start. We gotta draw a big tree. Da, 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 da. All right. Da, 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 da. A little shadow on the tree there. A little shade on that side. That's a big tree.
You never knew when you went into a show, into a day of work, what it was going to be like. You knew it was going to be different, but it was fun. I enjoyed it because also, from a personal point of view, it was fun for me because he allowed me to stretch my legs creatively.
My memories of Blinky, I don't think Blinky would be, he was a clown, but I don't think he was a buffoon. You know, there's a line between there. He never really did a lot of seltzer in your pants type of stuff. He would fool around and trip over things occasionally, but his communication was always with the kids on a much higher level.
Far yet. It's getting further away, isn't it, huh? Yeah, see? And way, 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 way down there, a little tree. This is called vanishing point. See, they vanish, they keep going. Down there, they vanish to a point.
He was big on safety for many years. In fact, that's one of the main reasons early on in the show at KKTV, I believe it was in Colorado Springs, he came up with the idea of a safety club. And he actually had little cards printed that said Blinky's Safety Club. And he kind of, I think in Denver, he peddled it to the AAA, I believe, Colorado or Denver AAA or Colorado AAA. He was very big on safety. That was, I would say, one running theme throughout his whole career was safety.
When I came to town to do the Blinky Show, nobody, but nobody, was talking safety to children. That's why I wanted to do something different. I didn't want to be and I'm not making fun of the clowns that are listening right now that tie animals out of balloons, because practically all of them did that, and I wanted to be different. Like I say, not to be rude to the other folks, I just wanted to be different. I wanted to be altogether different, a different type of a clown. So I talked safety.
Blinky's guests included firemen and policemen, reminding kids not to play with matches and to look both ways when crossing the street.
I took a hold of the handle and pulled it down, boiling, scalding water on the child. Never, ever, moms, please remember to put the handle back where the kids can't get to it. How about that?
Nice going, Blinky.
All right,
that's exactly right.
Like that.
Now, we have several things out here this morning, and I just wanted to talk a little bit about things that might burn children if they got too close.
All right.
One thing might be that pan.
That pan.
It could really burn somebody if they touched it when it was hot or on the stove.
Right.
Let's see. What else might burn? What if that coffee pot had coffee in it?
Mm-hmm.
Or hot water?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That could burn a child.
You better know it.
Hot spot spotters don't touch things that are hot.
Blinky became known as the safety clown, and his coloring book summed it up best.
Blinky, Blinky, I'm like you. I'm for safety through and through. I'll never race when I cross streets. A speeding car, it always beats. Guns and matches, not for me. I know better, yes siree. I'll always play the safety rule, and I'll grow up to finish school.
Through the 60s and 70s, the loose style of Blinky's Fun Club was a mainstay for kids before school. The format worked for Blinky, but his approach was hard for the production crew to follow.
I struggled with that for a while, early on. I was maybe 8 years into television. This was my first big show that I was directing. And I felt it should be done a little differently. But the more I worked with the guy and the other talents on the show, the more I realized it fit them better. I could get more good reaction out of them.